lot of things going on in the backstage area. Bigelow and Awesome with that big Paul Park back there. The Misfits in action, obviously down based on what happened in London to their leader, General Retchin. But General Retchin did not get down at all, Mike.
Well, it seemed like the Misfits were a little down, a little depressed about, well, I guess the turn of Major Guns, as well as General Retchin's loss of the U.S. title. But I think that pep talk maybe turned them around.
All right, we've just been given word that what we're about to see is Commissioner Mike Sanders' response to Ric Flair's mandate earlier in the telecast. The mandate, of course, that he make a decision as to his next Cruiserweight title defense. We're going to see a six-man fight at the business today. The winner of this match gets a shot at Sanders and the Cruiserweight title in Mayhem. How about that?
Well, you remember it was this past Monday on Nitro when the CEO, Ric Flair, laid down the law that Sanders had 48 hours to think of a situation to defend that Cruiserweight title. And this is what he's come up with. Guys, six of the greatest Cruiserweights in the world today. Four of these six are
himself. And look at this. Team Canada in the position of prime time in the other corner by himself. But he also had a watch out for the three Yankees ringside.
I don't believe it. He said it, Stevie. The three Yaks at ringside.
That's right, man. He took the words right out of my head.
Yeah, we got a turncoat Yak right there. I'm sorry, fans, I said
no,
that.
There is a three Yak limit at ringside. I'm going to get Mr. Golden in that. But, Peter, as it may, tell me, who do you think is the favorite in the six-way four-corner match? Please tell me that. What about you, buddy?
You know, when you really think about
it, there's Paisley, but IA, they trusted her. We look at a lot of bigger, but look at this.
One of the best in the... Look at that. You see what I'm...
She tried to trip him up, but Loco once again.
I just seen Paisley stay over there to talk to him.
That was attempted Yak interference.
That was a good move. Look at that. Good move in the ring by Loco to let the girl take care of himself, so to speak.
What has that been to Major Gun?
Oh, I told you. Watch him at ringside.
Oh, she's a disturber, that Major Gun's in.
I think the referee needs to get back in the ring for these Yaks.
I tell you what, Charles Robinson is one of the greatest referees in all of WCW, and he is trying to take charge on the outside. Oh, wait a second.
Wait a minute.
Oh, wait a minute.
Wait.
Oh! What is he thinking? He's trying to paintbrush. Here was the man, Sergeant AWOL, who personally tried to take care, if you'll recall, of Major Gun. He was the personal bodyguard, so to speak.
You know, AWOL may not be the sharpest knife in the drawer, but he knows straight from wrong.
I'll tell you one thing. He's okay with me, and I'm down with him, because when a Yak get out of line, you need to go put him back in line, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, but how come security? Did Lance Storm arrange for the security to take...
Because
the referee's having security send all the women back. So, Stevie, I guess you would say we're going to be Yakless. It's just here, so it remains to be seen exactly what that phone conversation was really about. And Mike, another great interview with Buff Bagwell. Buff Bagwell has been quite a performer in WCW.
Lots of interesting comments from Bagwell about the heat that he has in general with people in World Championship Wrestling, and in particular with the chosen one, Jeff Jarrett.
Here comes the turn show to Long and Lance Storm.
Well, the United States title went back.
So fast. How can you do that, Tony?
Well, it's just a sticker, Steve. That's all it is. We do like Major Guns when they win it, though, so, don't we?
Tony, get your mind off the gutter.
I think security finally got back on its feet that time, and here,
there's Major Guns. I don't have to tell you guys that.
Watch the Yak
Booker.
Watch the Yak Booker. Get your mind off the Yak.
Stay away from the Yak.
Keep the fighter.
What's this?
What is he doing?
Oh, clears her out.
What is she thinking?
I don't condone hitting a woman.
Why would she attack him like that? Why would she try to slap him?
But with Major Guns, I might make an exception.
Oh, prime time.
What did he jump from?
Here's Team Canada. He's done it.
Here's the answer. She was a diversion for Team Canada. But look at Booker T fight back.
Single-handedly fight back.
Duggan's down.
Guns has got the flag, and prime time's got the champion. Or he did momentarily. Prime time doubled over.
He's out.
Oh!
What is wrong with this guy?
That glass hole was just a wake-up call for Booker T.
She hit him on the back of the head. What in the world?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
There's nobody to save her.
I'm waiting for this.